Well, it used to be, there was a time, as they say, when most sane people in this country believe that bombing American citizens with military drone strikes in this country just because you don't like their politics, a little over the top, maybe a little too far, maybe not the unity we were looking for, but things have changed. Supporters of Donald Trump, it turns out, were so dangerous that maybe they do deserve hellfire missiles raining down on their homes. Watch.
We had a policy, and it was very controversial. It was carried out under the Bush years and under the Obama years, of attacking terrorism at its root, of going after and killing, and in the case of Amar al-Awlaki, an American, a Yemeni American, with a drone strike for the crime of inciting violence, inciting terrorism. Mitch McConnell was in the Senate then. He was in the Senate after 9/11, too. How does Mitch McConnell, who understands that the way you root out terrorism is to take on, in the case of Islamic terrorism, kill those who incite it, how does he not vote to convict someone that he said on the floor of the Senate incited an insurrection?
Yeah. Okay, we play a lot of pretty over-the-top video on this show, particularly from that channel and that news anchor. Save that tape. No matter what happens next, that will live forever as one of the craziest things ever said on cable television and one of the most ominous. But it's a sign of the moment we're in. The question is, how do we get out of this moment? I want to bring you next a man who's thought this through and, we think, struck a hopeful note. Russ Vought was the director of the White House Office of Management and Budget in the last administration. He's now the president for the Center for American Restoration, which is what we need. He joins us now. Russ, thanks so much for coming
on. Thanks for having me, Tucker.
So I don't think we need to make the case to our viewers that we're in an unprecedented time, people saying stuff like that on television. How do we get out of it?
Sure. I think what's important is that we need to remember to stay on offense on these particular issues on which they are pushing us at the front. These are the cultural issues. These are the America First issue. These are the issues, the theme that you've been talking about for many years, Tucker. And that's where the American people, the forgotten men and women across this country, this is where they want their people in Washington to fight for them and not to go back to the business as usual 4 or 5 years ago. And so that's what this center is all about. We want to restore a political consensus in this country that we are for God, we are for country, and we are for community, and that our only way out of this is to keep building that country and to restore that consensus in this country.
Do we have leaders who believe that and can articulate it, do you think?
I think we have some, but we need to build their ranks and we need to arm them. We need to provide a network of activists across the country that are right there willing to fight with them and so that they can know and hear and have that encouragement. But we need people who are willing to stand in difficult, tough fights in this town. It's easy to be for tax reform. It's easy to be for education
right.
policy reform. It's hard to be for big tech reform. It is hard to get us out of endless wars. And so that's where we really need to keep fighting on those cultural America First issues.
I get so distressed and discouraged looking at leaders in the Republican Party, not all of them, but I'm thinking of one in particular who has the most power in the Senate, tweeted the other day that the real problem is Vladimir Putin, some internal thing he was doing of zero interest to most people, I would say, including me. Can people like that be brought around to the obvious, which is you have to protect and serve your voters in order to justify your salary?
Time will tell, Tucker, but I think what's important is that we insist that these issues that we've been talking about for the last 4 or 5 years are the agenda. There's no going back. And so when we have leadership in the House and the Senate talking about trying to keep us in these wars, go back to passing amnesty bills, that's where we got to say, no, we're not doing that. And then to be able to look forward and to figure out why is it so that these issues and these ideas have taken so long to get on the agenda for Washington, D.C.?
Yeah. I mean, you're looking at, as far as I can tell, a situation where everyone with power has one view, a very self-serving view, in my opinion, and then the majority of the country, regardless of partisan affiliation, on the issues is on the other side. Like, what's the point of being in Afghanistan? Should we really open the borders? But it doesn't seem like the people with that view, the majority view, have any power at all.
Well, that is one of the reasons why I think we've got to do voter integrity reform. We've got to do big tech reform, because if we lose our voice, and right now we are in danger of losing our voice, and your last segment just got at it with regard to how they are calling us all terrorists, insurrectionists. If we lose our voice, we've got no movement. And so this is a real precarious moment. It needs leadership. And our center is trying to rally leaders across this country to have a voice in Washington, D.C.
Russ, I appreciate your hopeful position on this and the clarity of what you just said. Thank you.